Tasmanian farmers' appetite to innovate and seek differentiation with high-end products in agriculture never ceases to amaze. From a unique and extraordinary set of freehold islands off Tasmania's far northwest coast, fourth-generation farmer on the island, Keith Hammond, takes up the family story.
The islands were purchased in 1916 by our great-grandfather, Captain James Holliman. During the Holliman era, they had the dairy cattle and then also sheep. Cheese factory used to export 60 tonne of cheese a year to England. Had a school. At one point there was over 70 people living on the island, and it used to be quite a vibrant community over there. We've been operating a beef farm there since the early 60s. My brother and I took it over in 1980. The early 90s we decided that the future in the beef game was going to be with Wagyu cattle. So we imported Wagyu embryos from the United States and Canada.
In 94 we put our first embryos in, and we, over time, over about a 10-year period, we increased the herd up to about 2,000 breeders. 4 years ago started our own brand, and we've been working very closely with a family-owned company called Greenham's, and they own an export abattoir in our local town, and they do a fantastic job of high-quality beef. And so we've got a Robbins Island Wagyu brand. It's the only Tasmanian Wagyu brand in existence. About 90% of it goes export, about 10% stays domestic in Australia. So this beef now is going all over the world.
Yes, the famous swimming Wagyu from Tasmania's beautiful and remote circular head. The highest quality meat available, exported all over the world to high-end hospitality and high-end retail customers. We'll be right back.